I met Aya in 1998, where I replaced him as the most handsome son to my parents. Aya, I'm incredibly proud to be standing here and look at how grown up you are. I've had 24 years of memories seeing you grow up from a shy little boy to a very handsome, capable young man you are today. I still remember the days where you would force me to talk to anyone in public for you, and you'd also make me pick up all the phone calls from all the aunties and uncles. It is amazing how much a beard has changed your life. Ever since you started growing your beard, I noticed that you spent hours checking yourself out in the mirror, and you seem a lot more confident now.
Congratulations, Vinod. You made such an amazing catch, because Ayad has always been a very hard catch for everyone. We all know that she's very picky when she comes to boys, and you're the perfect match for her, Vinod. But don't send her too much food, you will spoil her. Today, Ayesha was the person I was supposed to grow old with, but she chose true love over a boring single life with me. But I'm 100% sure that you will take care of her no matter what. And also, I would like to add, I had the chance to meet Vinod for the first time on my birthday, like 2 weeks ago. As a matter of fact, I hate birthdays, but my bestie always comes up with the best ideas to make my day special. And talking to Vinod for the first time made me believe what a genuine person he is. And I realized that, yeah, he's the perfect man for my bestie. And I'm repeating this once again, as I said that day, Vinod, you are one of the most handsome boys that I've ever seen in my life. Literally, I felt like I was around a celebrity when I was with you. So Ayesha, remember, we are so damn lucky to have him.
Thank you. darling. There's not much they can
say. One story I wanted to say is Ayesha and I were close in the guild, and she was one of the house captains. So one issue I had with most of our house captains when we had to confront each other was they'd always be like, oh no, I didn't do that. Oh no, it's not how it went. I tried my best. But the funny thing with Ayesha was she would always be like, oh yeah, I did that. I'm sorry. And like you'd be suffering with your anger without an outlet. But she'll be the first to own up and be like, oh hey, no, it was my fault. So we know that I think you're a really lucky guy because you wouldn't have to fight with her. She'll be like, oh sorry, this happened. But then you'll be drowning in your own anger without an outlet. So all the best with that.
Every kiss is woe. They say no when you know. Well, I know you're the one. Some people bring you a million blessings. Some people teach you a million lessons. All that I learned, it wasn't my turn. It wasn't the right time.
Dear Ayesha Akkam, once again, I want to mention how beautiful you look today. You are one of the most honest and caring persons I've met. You are patient and you understand Ayesha as a person, and you're able to connect with him that I thought was not possible. I can honestly tell how much of a positive impact you've made on his life. Within the past few months, you've talked to him. A few days before you visited Australia, it was the first time I saw Ayesha clean his room. It was the first time I got a Christmas present as well. And after you left, it was the first time I saw him read a book. So thank you, Akka, for marrying Ayesha. No refunds anymore. I can finally have a clean bathroom and a clean garage at home. It's all your problem now.
Time and time again, if you let me to your hello. You are my everything. I give up everything. Show me the darkest parts of your heart, I ain't gonna run.